Okay. Hello, and welcome to week five of Count 1115. First, housekeeping. I want to remind you about the due date for assignment one, part one. It is a Sunday, June the 9th. And then I'm going to, how do I download? Link. I want to download this assignment. Let me see. Oops. I try to download this assignment. Looks like I can't. Let me see, is this file upload? It is strange. I cannot open the. I assume you can open it. Has somebody tried to open assignment one part one? Under assignments, then assignment one part one. Yeah. Oh, here,
It
from
doesn't
here.
open for me. Sorry.
You can open it?
No.
No?
Do I just click on the?
You click on this, you should have a Word document. I teach Monday class, students can open it. Copy assignment, no. It's down. If I open it, it just gave me this edit assignment. Quick. Oh, Ken, thank you so much. You can open it. Okay. Okay, try to open it, then I will explain. Thank you so much, Ken Man. Thank you, Aisa. Thank you, Cam. Okay, looks like you can open it. So basically, this assignment asks you to choose a topic of your own. The topic could be a wedding plan, could be a job search, could be create a website, could be construct a home, could be conduct computer training. So you name it, you choose a topic, and then you need to specify the objective of the your project. Just use one or two sentences, state the objective of your project. And then you are asked to create 12 tasks. Enter task duration. Set up task relationship. For example, finish start. Or start relationship. Okay. So basically, that is the requirement of assignment one. Last chance to see if I can open it. No. Okay, so that is a, sorry, I cannot open the assignment for you. You can open it. Question for assignment one, part one. This assignment is 8%. 8%. Okay. So what we are going to do today, we are going to do Microsoft Project Chapter 7 and Chapter 8. Okay, Chapter 7 and Chapter 8. Next week, we are going to do Chapter 9, Chapter 10. Next week, Chapter 9, Chapter 10. And then we finish Microsoft Project. Next week, finish project. Then in week 7, 2 weeks from today, we are going to have our test 2. Test 2 cover Microsoft Project Chapter 1 to Chapter 10. The format of test 2 would be similar to test 1. You have 1 hour to complete 30 multiple choice questions. And you can find the test under assessment, then quizzes. I haven't released test 2 yet. Just a reminder also, you need to complete quiz 2 before you do test 2. Okay, strongly suggest you do quiz 2. Okay. Okay, so that is where we are, where we are going. Any questions? You can type in your question in chat area or unmute yourself. I got one question. Do we have to write down the steps? Do we just perform the task? Good question. For assignment one, task one, you do not write down the steps. You just perform the task in project without writing down the steps. Okay? Just carry out the project steps in project software. Remember, you need to use Windows Virtual Desktop, the Microsoft project software to do it. Okay. All right. So, any questions? Last reminder, remember, I only teach week 1 to week 7. After week 7, I will go on vacation. Professor Lucas Lai will take over from me to teach second part of the course, Microsoft Access Database. Okay, so just let you know, two professors are teaching the same course. Okay, if you have questions, any questions, I hope to get your question answered before I go on vacation. So my last day would be today is week 5, 6, 7. So June 21st, June 20 is my last day. You have any questions, you'd better email me before June 20. After June 20, I am not available. Okay, I'm not available. Okay, so that is the course logistics. I also post the announcement on what we need to do
Professor,
for.
where is the link to open the project file?
Where is the link to open the project file? To open project file, you need a Windows Virtual Desktop. The link is here. If you go to announcement, during week 1 announcement here, week 1 and week 2. Everybody, please open the Windows Virtual Desktop. We need to use this one to do chapter 7 and 8 today. So click this link. I need two factors. I'll kick you off my phone. Oh. Okay, and on the bottom left corner, you have this start button. Now you can open project software.
Professor, I can't get the link to the virtual desk.
I will send you the link. Give me one moment.
Thank you.
Can you tell it?
I will go to the announcement. So you go to our course website. There are many places you can find this Windows Virtual Desktop link. One way is go to announcement. Announcement, scroll down. Oh, sorry, this is not the class. Our class is.
I got it now. Thank you.
Oh, okay, thank you. Great. Okay, now I go to my Windows Virtual Desktop blank project. So make sure you can open a new blank project. Get ready for chapter 7, chapter 8. Okay, now I'm going to open my textbook. So today is chapter 7 and 8. We do chapter 7 first. In chapter 7, it is about format and share your plan. So we are going to go over customize Gantt chart, how to customize Gantt bar, Gantt table. And then we are going to add tasks to timeline, create custom report, copy view and report, finally print pre-report and views. Okay. The hands-on is due actually in class, but I can extend it to midnight if you need extension. Okay. Can you tell me how to open? Yeah, I order project. So I'm opening project now, okay? Okay, so this is chapter 7. Remember, you need to read the textbook by yourself. So in chapter 7, it tells detailed steps, see, explanation. What is the Gantt table? This is the Gantt table. And this is the Gantt chart. And where is timeline? This part is timeline. Okay, so you read over the textbook. In class, we'll just focus on the hands-on part. So I will directly go toward the end of chapter 7. You have a practice task. The practice task is our hands-on. Okay. I pause for a moment. Any questions on what we're supposed to do? In case you cannot follow my live demonstration, remember I showed you I also posted YouTube video. I just want to tell you where to find it for all the chapters for project. See the videos? Go to content. Videos. Then videos again. Not here. I should have all the chapters available. Lecture recordings. This lecture recording refers to the YouTube video I created in the past semester. Please pay attention to content only. Do not pay attention to the due date because it is out of date. So you can find all chapters for MS project. So today we are going to do chapter 7, chapter 8. I'm going to copy those YouTube video link on the chart. In case you cannot follow my steps, you can watch the video to catch up. Or you need to go back, chapter 7, chapter 8, YouTube video, okay? This way, I hope to accommodate most students' need. If you can follow my steps, that's great. If you cannot follow my steps, you can watch this YouTube video, okay? This is a YouTube video, and we also have the live lecture recording. So if you go to Zoom, each week, I recorded this lecture. It is under Zoom Cloud Recordings. Cloud Recordings, okay? So the past recordings are here. This is week 1, May 9. Week 2, May 16, week 3, May 23rd, week 4, test 1, no lecture. Today is week 5. Okay? So you can get the live lecture recording here to catch up. Okay? Okay, now let's directly jump in to chapter 7, the task. You need to open simple format plan in chapter 7 on OneDrive, George Brown. Simple format plan. I'm going to also open my physical textbook. So go remote desk. Click File, Open. When you click one, you need to open from OneDrive, George Brown. But now I do not have OneDrive, George Brown. It is just OneDrive. So you need to click Signing In. And then click Add Account on the bottom. Click Add Account on the bottom. Now type in your George Brown email. Now I can see one drive, George Brown. I double click to open it and locate the data file folder for COMP 1115. It is chapter 7. Simple format. This is the file we need to open. Remember, once you open a file, save as first. Click Save As. Save in OneDrive, George Brown. Remember in week one, I asked you to create a hands-on folder on OneDrive, George Brown. Okay. Hands-on folder. So the file name, simple format, underscore your initials. Chapter 7. Okay, so this is chapter 7. Go to practice task. We just open simple format plan. Now, step one, in Gantt chart view, manually schedule task. For manually scheduled task 9. So in step one, you just do observation. So you locate task 9. This is task 9. Okay. And if you observe, the color of the bar chart for task 9 here. This is the bar for task 9. It is different from other tasks.
But it's fine. Honestly, the only
This task, the color is different because task 9 is manually scheduled. How do you know it is manually scheduled? You see the icon here? This icon represents manually scheduled. This is auto scheduled. Other tasks are auto scheduled, but just task 9 manually scheduled. Okay. So this is step one. And step two, we do nothing for step one, just observe the color is different for task 9. Step two, apply predefined orange color style. Apply orange color style. So go back to here. Go to Gantt chart format. On click more button on Gantt chart style. And then under presentation style, select. Orange, this one here. This one is the orange. Okay, orange color style. So click it. See, all the bar chart has been changed to orange. This
Professor,
is.
please can you repeat that? Under the grand chance, where do we go to see the more buttons?
Click Gantt chart format. This is more button here. You see, where is my mouse? Click here, you see more button. I undo it. This button here, down arrow key here.
Yes, okay, thank you.
Click this one, you see under presentation styles. Select the second from last. Questions? Okay, we finished step two. Step three, task six is Amaya Stone. And we are asked to change. By default, diamond shape represent Maya Stone. Remember what is Maya Stone? If a task duration is zero, duration is zero. That is a task Maya Stone. Now we are asked how to open book. You have to buy the textbook in order to open it. Okay, this is my electronic textbook here. The book is here. Okay, so we do step three. Now we are asked to apply italic text to task six. So locate task six. Click the name for task six. And then go to task. Under font group, select italic. And then click the yellow background fill color. So the result should be this. The name for task six, italic with yellow background. Okay, questions? We finished step three. Step four. Task six, still in task six, we want to change the diamond shape to star shape here. Change the diamond shape to star shape. So see, this is the diamond shape for task six. How do you change to star shape? Double click this diamond. Double click. It is not this one. Double click. Double click the shape so that you have format bar. I pause for a moment. You need to practice. And now under the bar shape, from the shape drop down list, you can select a star. Click OK button. Now it has been changed to star. Questions? Okay, so we completed customize a Gantt chart view. Next, we are going to add a task to our timeline view. Step one, add the following tasks to timeline. So first of all, where is timeline? You see where is my mouse? Here. Timeline is this part, is the timeline. See, timeline from here to here. Timeline. Okay. So double click anywhere in timeline. Double click. Double click anywhere in timeline. I see the question. You cannot find the book. You go to our course website. You need to purchase a book, okay? Then you go to here. Go to content. Go to data files. Data files for MS Project textbook. The fourth link is the textbook. See, you need to make a purchase. There are copyright. Please do not just copy from another student, PDF or whatever. If you are caught, you may charge academic misconduct. Okay? So this is where you buy your textbook. Okay? Different price depending on do you want paper book or do you want ebook? Looks like ebook is cheaper. Okay. So I can copy this link to chat area. All right. So now we do step one, add the following tasks to the timeline. The first step, double click anywhere in timeline. And then under timeline format, insert existing tasks. Insert existing task. And now you click planning phase. Planning complete. Internal launch phase. Public launch phase. Author travel and appearance. So you need to enter those tasks. Then click OK. So those are the tasks you need to enter. Step one. Can you repeat step again? Yes, I can repeat the step. We are doing step one. To do step one, you need to double click anywhere here. Double click anywhere. Then you have timeline format. In insert group, you click existing tasks and then select those tasks. Planning phase, internal launch, etc. Try to not make this bigger. Okay. So click OK button. I finished step one. Add a task.
Professor, mine is not bringing out where I can add the tax. I double clicked, but it's not bringing out anything.
Okay. You need to double, you see the timeline? You need to double click anywhere in timeline. So if I go I'll redo it. So you need to double click. Anywhere here. See, where's my mouse? Did you see this part?
Yes.
Double click so that you have timeline format.
Okay.
After that, insert existing tasks. Okay, we completed step one. You see, did you see the name we entered? We add a name to timeline. Okay. Okay, step two. We finished step one. Okay, step two. In timeline view, switch to the taskbar to a callout so that it is full title is visible. Callout. See, this is the, if you mouse here, this is also travel and appearance. You cannot see the full title. We need to use call out. Okay. So how do you use call out? So you select, click this button, click this task, and then under current selection, it is still in timeline format. Under current selection, select display as callout. Display as callout. Now you see the complete name, author, travel, and appearance. Questions? All right, so we completed add task to timeline. Next, we do customize report. Step one, display resource cost overview report. Resource cost overview. So go to report, cost, resource cost overview. So you now have this resource cost overview. It is showing the cost redistribution in pie chart. The orange represents the cost. The blue represents work. Work means human resource, okay? And this is in the cost status. If you scroll down, you can also find a table showing the cost details. Okay, questions? Okay, next step. Step two, apply blank background chart style for the pie chart. Double click the pie chart. Double click anywhere here. You activate chart design. And then under chart style, select style 7.
Sorry,
Style.
professor, how did you
Yes.
get to that page? You go to report and then.
Correct. Report cost, resource cost overview.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for asking. Okay, now double click this pie chart and go to chart design, select style 7.
Professor, I
Questions?
don't even know how we did this pie chart, so I'm sorry to ask.
How did you do the pie chart? Okay, I repeat, how do you add background? You click this, double click this pie chart. Under chart design, select this one. Click this one. Style 7.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, we finished step two. Step three, apply gray background table style to the table. So you may need to scroll down to see the table first. So this is table. Select this table. I need to move my screen. Scroll. Double click table. Double click. Then click table design. Under table design, you have table style. Click this more button here, the down pointing arrow. You can see more table style. And then select under the best match, select same style one, accent three. This one here. Okay, so you formatted the table. Questions? Okay, so next we do the copy views and report. Step one, display Gantt chart so that tasks 7 to 14 are visible. So go back to Gantt chart, go to task, click Gantt chart view, the more button, select Gantt chart. So make sure you are in Gantt chart view by click Gantt chart, then Gantt chart. After that, you need to see task 7 to task 14 here. So I can see task 7 to task 14. So when you see task 7 and 14, you are asked to copy a picture. Okay, so how do you do that? So you go make sure task menu is selected. Click down pointing arrow for copy and select copy picture. For full screen, and then click OK button. Okay, now We need to
Sorry, where
upload.
did you go for that? Where did you get copy picture from?
Oh yeah, it is here. Thank you for asking. Go to task. Did you see copy button on the clipboard group? There is a down pointing arrow. You have copy picture.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for asking. And next, we are going to open a Word document in Windows Virtual Desktop. I repeat, open Word document in Windows Virtual Desktop. Otherwise, you cannot paste. Oh, let me try. So if you, I open the Word document from my computer, local computer, and if I go Control V, I cannot paste, okay? So you have to open a Word document under Windows Virtual Desktop. Okay, so how to open a Word document under Windows Virtual Desktop? So remember, this is your Windows Virtual Desktop. Remember, on the bottom left, you have Start button. Remember how we opened the project here? Now you open Word. Open Word. So this Word document is in Windows Virtual Desktop. It is not on your computer. It is on Windows Virtual Desktop.
Professor, can you please show that again? How you
Yeah.
copy that thing?
Yes, I can repeat how to copy. First, you need to see the Gantt chart view here. Then you go to task. Did you see copy? There is a
Yeah.
down arrow beside this copy. Click this down arrow. You can see that copy picture. Okay. After you copy picture, you open Word document from Windows Virtual Desktop. Okay, Windows Virtual Desktop to open Word document. And then you paste here. Click paste button. See? You copy it and paste. Questions? Okay. Next, copy full size of detailed timeline. Copy timeline. Okay, step four. So go back to here. So double click timeline so that you have timeline format. And then copy timeline, this button, copy timeline. Select full size. Full size. And now open your Word document. Remember, we copied something in Word document. Okay, and then paste. Put your mouse here, paste. Okay, so you paste the timeline. We did step four, five together, copy, paste. Now step six, copy resource cost overview and paste it in Word document. So now, where is my resource cost overview? Remember, how do we get resource cost overview? Go report. Report, cost, resource cost overview, now this is resource cost overview, and how do we copy? So click anywhere in this report. Now click report design. Copy report. Under report design, copy report. Then go to Word document.
How can I find a copy report? I didn't get that.
And paste. Give me 1 second. Okay. I need to paste. Paste. Okay, what we are. Good select. Paste picture. Paste. Maybe here. Maybe select image. Okay. So this is how you copy and paste. So go back to your question. How do you find copy? You need to, did you have resource cost overview?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Then you go to, you click this resource. You have to click it. Click somewhere here so that you have report design. If you don't have report design, the chances are you did not click anywhere here, anywhere in this resource sheet view. Then you are going to have report design and the copy report button is here.
Yeah, I got it. Thank you.
Oh, great. Glad you got it. All right. So where is my, okay, textbook here. So we finished this copy and paste. Okay. Last thing is print or print preview here. How do we do the print preview is the last task. Okay. Go to file. Print. This is print preview here. This is resource cost overview. If you want to see Gantt chart preview, you go back, you go to task, Gantt chart, you display Gantt chart, then you go file, print, and you get a print preview here. All right. Okay, in summary, we finished chapter 7. Congratulations. In chapter 7, we customized Gantt chart view, add task to timeline, customize report, copy view and report, print preview. Okay. Shall we all take a break? If you have questions, please hold your question. We all need a break. After break, I answer your question first, then we do chapter 7. Okay. So I'll give you time. Make sure you have some water, stretch, get some fresh air. Come back at 1:15. We do chapter 8. Okay. Oh, thank you so much, Cassandra. Yeah, I should unmute. Yeah, thank you. In chapter 8, we add progress. For example, some tasks are just 45% complete. How do we add 45% to the task? Same baseline for the plan. What is the baseline? It is a decided time and plan. Track project as scheduled. Enter percentage completion. Enter actual values for the task. So that is chapter 8. Remember, you need to go over the textbook chapter 8 by yourself. See, this is the textbook for chapter 8. Give you detailed explanation on, for example, how to save a baseline, give you the steps. So you go to project, then schedule, set baseline. So that is the textbook. Give you detailed instructions for how to carry out a task. In class, we focus on the practice task toward the end of the chapter. Here. Chapter 8, practice task. So we need to open simple trust track baseline file. Everybody open simple track baseline file. This is the file we did for chapter 7. Remember we saved it on OneDrive dot brown. Do not submit until you complete chapter 8. You need to submit chapter 7 and chapter 8 together. Okay. All right, so everybody go to file open. OneDrive dot brown. The file should be in data file, OneDrive dot brown data file. Chapter 9. Oh, sorry, chapter 8. We do chapter 8. We are asked to open simple track baseline. Remember after you open it, quick file save as OneDrive.brown and should save in hands home folder. The file name, original file name, followed by your initials. We could save. Okay, now questions. We haven't do any steps yet. We just opened the file, simple track baseline in chapter 8 folder. Step 1, save baseline for entire project. So you go to project. Under schedule group, set baseline, for entire project. Then click OK button.
Sorry, can you repeat that again?
Oh, sure. go to project, under schedule group, select set baseline, then set baseline, and just click OK button. Thank you for asking. It work?
Yeah, perfect. Thank you.
Excellent. So we finished step one. Step two, switch to task sheet view. So go to task. Oops, I have to click OK here. Do I have anyone? So go to task, under Gantt chart view, select task sheet view. So this is task sheet. Have the task name, duration, start, finish. For your assignment one, part one, which is due in few days, you are asked to create 12 tasks. Right now, this project has 24 tasks. You are asked to create 12 tasks. Enter the duration of the task. Okay, and then set task relationship. That is your project one, part one. Okay, we finished step two. Step three, display variance table. What is a variance table? The variance table is the variance. What is variance? It is the difference between actual value and planned value. Step three, display variance table. So everybody in this button on top left corner, above row zero, beside column I, that is select all button. If you right click your mouse on top left corner of this table, you can select variance. Right click your mouse, select variance. So this is the variance table, showing you the task name, start finish date, baseline start, okay, etc. So that is the step three. We finished questions. Next, we are going to track the task as scheduled. For this one, we need to open another data file. The file name is Simple Tracked Actuals. Simple Track Actuals. So go file, open. OneDrive, George Brown. OneDrive, George Brown. Go to data file. Chapter 8. Then you found simple track actuals. As usual, you save file as. OneDrive, George Brown. Go to hands-on folder. The file name, original file name, underscore your initials. Questions. Now, step one, use options in update project dialog box to record work has been completed as scheduled. Go to project. Under status group, click update project. And then update work as completed through select January 18, 2023. Sorry for the noise. We finished step one.
Sorry, Professor, after we change the date to January 18, 2023, do we do anything else or just
No,
okay?
no, just press okay. Yeah.
Okay.
So next, we need to enter task completion percentage. Set 100% complete for task 5, 6, and 8. So click task 5. Then click task. Under schedule group, you have 100% button. Click it. After you click 100%, what happened was in Gantt bar, see, there is a solid horizontal line across this bar. Do the same thing for task 6. Click task 6. Go to task. Under schedule group, click 100%. Then for task 8, click 100%. Okay. So that is step one. No, step two for task 9. Enter 50% complete. 50% complete. So go task 9. Click 50%. When you click 50%, what happened was you see the Gantt bar here. There's a half solid horizontal line here. That means 50%. All right, so we finish this step. Next, enter actual values for task. Step one, use the tracking table to record task 9. Require 24 hours of actual work. So how do I get a tracking table? Go to select all button, which is located on top left corner of Gantt table, above row 0 on the left hand side of I, column I. So right click your mouse, you have tracking. So now you have tracking table. Have the task name, actual start, actual finish, percent complete, etc. Okay. So you are asked to enter 24 hours for task 9. 24-hour actual work. This button is the split bar. You can move to the right to see the complete. This is the
So can
actual
you show
work.
this step again? Sorry.
Sure. Right click your mouse, right click your mouse on top left corner. Select the tracking.
Yeah, I did until that.
Excellent. Okay, now locate actual work column. You may need to move this split bar to the right in order to see actual work. Then locate task 9, type in 24HR. So 24 hours for task 9, that is the actual complete. Okay, so we finished step 1. Step 2, use options in update task dialog box for task 10. Started 1 working day behind schedule and required total of 7 days to complete. Okay. Okay, go task 10. Go task 10. And then go to project, update tasks. Okay, select this top. We are doing task 10, select top. Select task 10. Quick task on the ribbon. Under schedule group, you have mark on track, down pointing arrow. We need update task dialog box. I repeat, select task 10 first, then go to task on the ribbon. Under schedule group, click the down pointing arrow beside mark on track and then select update tasks. Now you have this update task dialog box. Okay. So the actual typing 6D, so 7D means 7 days. Actual needs 7 days to complete. And also for the start date, select January 27, 2023. I'll double check. So January 27, 2023, and actual duration 7 days.
Sorry, do we put the finish as well? Because mine doesn't, like, it didn't update the finish.
We don't put finish. We just put a start.
Oh, okay, updated. Okay.
Just put start and just put 7 day here.
Yeah, it worked. Yeah,
yeah.
Thank you.
Great. Then click OK button.
But for me, the finish one doesn't show any date. Do I need to put the date or it would update automatically?
Okay, your quick task turn, I repeat. Mark on track, update task. You need to enter two number, 170.
Yeah.
Then put down the start date. That's what you need to do.
Oh, now see how in your finish there is a date Monday 2/6/23. Mine doesn't show that.
What did you see?
In your screen, can you see after the start there's a finish and it says Monday 2/6/23. Mine doesn't show that date.
Okay, so what you need to do, you just type in those two numbers, forget what are the other information. They may
Okay.
something, yeah, okay. Just type in
Okay.
70, just type in January 27, 2023.
Okay, and then press okay.
Yeah, press okay.
Okay.
Thank you, Shani. Shani shared information. If you click okay, then go back. You may have the date changed. Click okay. Then if you do this again, you may have the updated information. Thank you, Shani, okay, for sharing your tips. Okay, so we finished step three. We clicked OK button. Step four. Use update dialog box for task 11. This task has 3 days actual duration, but still require 5 days remaining. Okay. Yeah, so this one is for task 11. Okay. Select task 11. Go to task, mark on task, update task. So actual, we need 3 days. Actual 3D. Remaining. Remaining is 5D, that's fine. And then type in January 26, 2023 as the start date. Oh, didn't maybe just need to enter 5D and 3D here. Then just click OK button.
Sorry, what was the date you entered?
Okay, I'll show you again. So go to update button. Actual is 3 day. Remaining is 5 day. Remaining is 5 day. Then click OK button. Okay.
So you didn't put anything in to start?
You could put, but it automatically will put it for you. You could put January 26, 2023. If you ignore it, when you go back later, it will show up January 26. Okay. Okay, that concludes chapter 8. So in summary, chapter 8 is about track progress. Remember in chapter 8, we did two files. Chapter 7, just one file. So total, you need to submit 3 files on Brightspace. If you choose to do submissions through Windows Virtual Desktop, you can directly grab the files from OneDrive George Brown. Otherwise, if you do submissions through your local computer, you have to download the file from OneDrive George Brown to your computer and then upload the files from your computer to Brightspace. So there are two methods. One, directly use the browser in Windows Virtual Desktop. Two, use local computer. You decide which method you want. Okay. So you go to assessment, assignment. Here, chapter 7 and 8. Okay. Next week, we'll do chapter 9, chapter 10. Questions? Do we need to submit Word file? We do not need to submit Word file, just the project file. Just submit three project file. To simplify, okay? Looks like I want to remind. I want to modify this one because some students need constant reminder. Okay, just a reminder, what is already overdue and what is upcoming dues. All here. Also, I want to send you the email. All right, so the lecture ends. If you do not have questions, feel free to go. Remember, you need to do assignment one, part one. If you have questions, I am here. But can I propose we take second break? If you have questions, you come back. If you don't have questions, you're done for today. Okay. Let me see what is the time now. Okay, come back at 2 o'clock for any questions and answer. Okay. Thank you very much for your participation. Yeah, welcome back. Hope you have a nice break. Before break, we completed chapter 8. So today we completed both chapter 7 and 8. Remember, we also have assignment 1, part 1 due. Okay, if you have any questions about the hands-on assignment, anything, I'm here. Feel free typing your question in chat area or unmute yourself. But I'm going to stop recording. So, see you in cyberspace.